Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the final big performance for both the Wind Ensemble and the Concert Band for this academic year. My name is Gerard Morris. I'm the director of bands here at the University of Puget Sound, and it's my privilege to conduct both of these ensembles. We have a really great concert planned for you tonight. It's a little bit different than we typically do at the end of the school year, but for every student that's on campus knows that we have one less week here at the end of the school year. We usually have one more in here before we had to the last day of classes and reading period. And so we had a lot of concerts crammed into the end of the school year, many of which are taking place still this weekend and early next week. And so we wanted to treat tonight kind of like a potpourri of lots of great music. And I programmed a lot of pieces, especially here with the concert band, through their feedback. We read pieces at the beginning of the semester, and then we kind of pick and chose what we wanted to play. So we have a lot of variety for you tonight. So once again, seated in front of you is the concert band. This is a non-audition ensemble at the university. Anybody can register who has the skill of playing a woodwind, brass, or percussion instrument, including keyboard, and join this group. So I'm going to introduce Julia, who's going to come to the microphone to introduce our first song.
Hi, everyone. So I just want to talk about this first piece that we're going to play. It's called Allegro Presto from Symphony No. 2 by Joseph Bologne. So Joseph Bologne was born in 1745 to the son of a French nobleman whose name was George Bologne, and his mother was enslaved by the Bologne family and given the name Nanon. Though Joseph was not the child of George Bologne's wife, his father loved Joseph very much, and George invested very heavily in his son's education, where his now famous skills in music and fencing were cultivated. Joseph Bologne became revered as one of the best swordsmen in all of Europe. He was made an officer in the court of King Louis the 15th and earned the title of Chevalier. He used his new title of Chevalier du Saint-Georges to launch his musical career. His skill as a violinist and composer garnered him so much favor in the French courts that he was nearly made the director of the Paris Opera. However, the performers for the opera petitioned to prevent his appointment due to him being of African descent. Despite the discrimination he encountered and he endured, Joseph Bologne Chevalier de Saint-Georges was the first known Western classical composer of African heritage, and he's one of the most remarkable characters in music history. So I hope you all enjoy. I've had so much fun learning this piece, and I hope you guys have fun listening to it.
Thank you.
Okay, so the next piece on the program is from a very different genre. This is titled The Seal Lullaby. It is by a rather famous composer, Eric Whitaker. And this arrangement was created by a friend of mine, Bob Ambrose, in a flex band arrangement. And the first piece was as well. So we're celebrating our seniors tonight, right? And so when the seniors started, it was fall of 2020. Yeah, right, exactly. Nobody wants to stuff, right? Ooh, I heard a few, yeah, right? It was a really, really difficult time, and we've endured, and we celebrate tonight. During COVID, a lot of composers were creating pieces with what they called flex instrumentation, meaning like, well, you have an A part, a B part, a C part, and a D part, and no matter what instruments you have, you can put different people on different parts and make it work. And so this works really, really well for smaller ensembles because then you can make sure that you have all the parts covered. So this second piece is no different. It is based on, you read the program note here, but Eric was contacted and asked to write some music for an animated picture that was based off of some of Kipling's poetry. And this is about the seal lullaby. This is the mother seal singing to her pup, and it's just a gorgeous little love song. So to read the poetry that it's based off of, I'm going to ask Sam Snow to come to the microphone.
Hush thee, my baby, the night is behind us, and black are the waters that sparkled so green. The moon o'er the combers look downward to find us, and rest in the hollows that rustle between. Where billow meets billow, then soft be thy pillow. O weary we flippering, curl at thy ease. The storm shall not wake thee, nor shark overtake thee, asleep in the arms of the slow swinging seas. Thank you. Enjoy.
Thank you.
So as mentioned, this is the concert each year where we celebrate our graduating seniors. And so we have two that are within the concert band. So the two seniors can just step forward here to the front and introduce them individually to you all. First, we have Julia Vahey. Her major is biology and music. And the plan upon graduation is to move back to San Francisco to pursue a job in biotechnology. Congratulations, Julia. And next we have Sam Snow. Sam is majoring in international political economy and minoring in French language. Planning to stay in the Tacoma, Seattle area and pursue a career within agriculture, specifically food security. Congratulations, Sam. And while I have the two seniors here, I just want to say thank you so much for the last 4 years. As I've mentioned earlier in our remarks at our dress rehearsal today, we've all been through a lot. We started together online. We had all these precautions that we clearly had to take to be safe, but that made making music very, very difficult, and we all know it. Unfortunately, we lost some people along the way to just, like, I don't want to do this anymore. It's just too much. It's too stressful. So I celebrate both of you who endured. You are survivors, and I'm so grateful that we're still making music together. So thank you so much. The third piece on the program here for us, and this is the last piece we're going to play individually, is called Hymn for Peace by Kevin Day. Kevin Day is a remarkable young composer who is a dear friend of mine. We actually commissioned Kevin Day to write President Crawford's inauguration fanfare many years ago when he was still a student down in Texas. And since that time, he has really grown into like a sensation all over the world, actually. Kevin wrote this little piece a few years back when he was struggling with some mental illness and depression. And he writes in the score that this piece is really about hope and that we all were struggling through this time, even that I just mentioned, that we've all been through together, and all of you too, all of us together. And the beautiful thing with this is it's about working through difficulty and finding a path forward. And I think you'll hear in this music that it is very melancholy at first. And then in the middle, you're going to hear a beautiful saxophone cadenza that's going to be performed. And that's the moment of awakening, like an epiphany. And then right after that, everything just seems more hopeful and at one point even triumphant. So here's Kevin Day's A Hymn for Peace. Thank you. For those of you who are artists, musicians that work or have played in smaller ensembles, one of the challenges is there's nowhere to hide. Like, everybody's a soloist, so congratulations, concert band, you did a great job. Some beautiful work. Now we're going to play a combined piece. I'm going to invite the Wind Ensemble to come out and join us. We've been working on this individually. This is something that you're going to hear again next week if you're at the Pops on the Lawn concert. It's selections from Black Panther. So let's just give us two seconds to get the Wind Ensemble out here, and then I'll have a few more words to introduce our student conductor, and then we'll take a quick intermission. So please just hold 1 second. Thank you. rather seamless. Thank you guys, that was great. So yeah, we practiced this like an hour ago. So at any rate, like I said, we just wanted to do something combined together. So this is Combined Wind Ensemble Concert Band. This piece is selections from Black Panther. It is going to be conducted by one of our advanced conducting students, Ray Kirchner. Ray is a music education major here at the university, and he has been nothing short of extraordinary in multiple ways. Incredible saxophonist, incredible artist, incredible teacher, pedagogue. I've watched him teach in my brass tech class, and just really born to teach. And so it's been really, really wonderful to have Ray as part of the advanced conducting course. He'll be conducting this next Wednesday as well on Pops on the Lawn, but you're gonna get a sneak preview right now. So without further ado, Ray Kirchner.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take a 10-minute intermission, and we'll be back with the Wind Ensemble. See you in a few. Thank you. Thank you. right, well, welcome back to the second half. The ensemble seated in front of you is the Wind Ensemble. This is one of our top performing ensembles here at the university by audition for membership in the ensemble. So these exceptional musicians you see in front of you had a really incredible spring semester. A month and a half ago or so, we celebrated the retirement of our longtime flute professor, Carla Fleigar, who's leaving at the end of the school year. And we managed to bring back like 34 alumni, and this ensemble played some of the most difficult repertory we have in our canon, and did so spectacularly. In the second half of the semester here, I'm like, we're gonna take it a little easier. I'm not sure if any of you came to the orchestra concert last Friday where they performed Tchaikovsky's Fifth Symphony, but that was a huge undertaking as well, and a major accomplishment for many of the students that are sitting on the stage. So we thought we were gonna take it a little lighter and have some fun here. But this is how crazy they are. 2 weeks ago, I'm like, hey, seniors, what do you want to play going out? We got all this pops music we can play. Let's keep it light, have some fun. They're like, we want to play Festive Overture. And the Shostakovich here, right? It's the first thing you're going to hear. And it's like, okay, this is a very challenging piece of music. If you don't know it, you're going to find out in a second. And I'm like, you guys, you got 2 weeks. It's like four rehearsals. And they're like, yeah, it's okay. We're going to do it. And I said, okay, so here we are. So we're going to kick things off here with one of the greatest overtures ever written, transcribed by Donald Hunsberger. This is Shostakovich's Festive Overture.
Thank you.
That's fun, right? Who doesn't want to hear that? So you maybe if you don't know that work, that you can understand now why the seniors were like, we want to play Festive Overture one more time. So yeah, just really, really wonderful to be able to do that. And for them to do that on like four rehearsals is kind of extraordinary. So bravo and congratulations, everybody. Next, we're moving on to a little Over the Rainbow, from the very famous cinematographic masterpiece, The Wizard of Oz. This is going to feature two of our seniors. This is Mia on clarinet and Chloe on alto saxophone. And I love this little transcription, and we just wanted to have some fun with it. This is kind of I like dedicating this in different ways. I think that it's very apropos for how many of you in the audience are seniors or graduating from Puget Sound this spring? Anyone out here? A few of you, yeah, raise your hand. You should be like, yeah, right? Right? I'm giving you permission to party at this one, right? Just like get a little crazy. So, but this is like, you know, somewhere over the rainbow where skies are blue, you know, and I think about, you know, your time here and all the moments we've all had together, but there's a new adventure that awaits you in just a few weeks here when you earn your degree. So this is dedicated to all of our seniors.
Thank you.
mean, isn't that just fantastic? Right. Congratulations, me and Chloe. Beautiful, beautiful work there. Okay, now it's time for me to recognize the seniors that are within the wind ensemble. We have quite a few more here that are graduating. So seniors, if you can make your way forward and just get yourself assembled here. And I see Dr. Doyle's on stage to help me here. We started this tradition just this year. And it's just going to be super fun moving forward, but we're offering graduation chords to members who are performing in our ensembles, and they're color-coded. They're for different ensembles or different colors and whatnot. And so all of the people in front of you are going to be receiving a chord, and Sam, of course, is going to have two because she played in both groups this semester, so congratulations, Sam. Okay, so I'm going to get things started here, and I think they're kind of in order from that end, I think, there too, Tracy, so, okay. Let's go. So first up, we have Grace Playstead. Grace is a flute performance and environmental policy and decision-making double degree with an honors emphasis. That's all just nuts to me, but that's great. I love you. Upon graduation, home to see her family, and then to the University of Denver Lamont School of Music for her master's in flute performance. Congratulations, Grace. Next, we have Jane Beacock. Jane is a clarinetist in the ensemble. She is earning a Bachelor of Arts in Psychology and a minor in Spanish. After graduation, Jane is going to the Oregon Coast Getaway with fellow clarinetists Mia and Levi. That sounds like fun. And then to spend time with her family in Vancouver, Washington, while she determines the next steps in her career. Congratulations, Jane. Next, we have Caitlin Kaduoka. Caitlin is also a clarinetist, and her major is molecular and cellular biology and Japanese. Upon graduation, Caitlin will be attending Southern California College of Optometry in Fullerton, California, starting the fall. Congratulations, Caitlin. Next, we have who you already met, Mia Stenberg. Mia is earning a Bachelor of Arts in Music and a Humanities emphasis. Mia will be attending the Longy School of Music in Boston this fall for her Master's in Music Education, Teaching Licensure, and Continued Clarinet Studies. Congratulations, Mia. Next up, we have Levi Walsh. Levi is also a clarinetist. We have a lot of clarinetists. Levi's major is a Bachelor of Arts in Music and a minor in French. Upon graduation, he is going to spend some time this next year applying for master's programs to attend the next year. Congratulations, Levi. Another soloist who you've already met, Chloe Montoya. Chloe is a major in music education. They are moving back to San Francisco and seeing where it takes them. Go, Chloe. That's a great plan. I love that. I'll come visit you in San Francisco, too. It's such a wonderful place. Next up, we have Rachel Ball. Rachel is in our horn section. Her major is Business Leadership Program and German Studies, and a minor in Music Inquiry. Her plan upon graduation is to go home for the summer and then travel to Austria in the fall, where she'll be working for approximately 9 months as an English teaching assistant with Fulbright Austria. Congratulations, Rachel. Next up, we have Maya Nilsson. They are an English literature with emphasis in creative writing major and a minor in Hispanic studies. Maya will be moving to Seattle to pursue a career in publishing and editing. Congratulations, Maya. Next up, we have Elias Tiemann, major economics, politics, and government, and a minor in music. Plans are to go to grad school, But it's going to take a little more time because Elias is planning on going overseas, potentially Germany, correct? Yeah, congratulations. Next up, we have Ian Dunlop. Ian is a Bachelor of Arts in Music major, and his plan upon graduation, and I read these the way that I get them from the students. I want you to know. Sleep for at least 72 hours straight. Okay, well, congratulations, Ian. You've already met Sam Snow, but here we are again, majoring in international political economy and minoring in French language. Is planning on staying in the Tacoma, Seattle area to pursue a career within agriculture, specifically in food security. Yes, Sam. And last but certainly not least, from our percussion section, Allie Davey. Allie, yes. Allie is a major in Japanese language and culture and minors in Asian studies and communication. Upon graduation, Allie will be staying in Washington to spend time with her family before going to teach English in Japan for a couple of years. Congratulations, Allie. Seniors, so just a few words. We've been through a lot, so it's the same thing with the concert band here, but you know, we all came together in that fall of 2020, and we were like, what is going on? How do we do this? How do we play in an ensemble when we can't move our air? And you wore those feedback masks. Remember those lovely things? You know, that hung off your face and all that good stuff, sitting 8 feet apart when we were actually allowed to come back together, and you endured. And as I said to our concert band seniors too, you guys are survivors. And I know it's been hard, I know it's been rough, but you know, I'm a Marine, so you know, it just makes us stronger. And I cherish the time we've had together. I know it hasn't always been easy, but you guys have always risen to the occasion, and you have literally laid down some of the most memorable performances we have ever had on this campus over the last 4 years. So thank you so much for your talent, time, dedication. I love you all dearly, and I can't wait to see what you do next. Congratulations. Okay, so now we have one more piece on the program. Yeah, head back now. So, see, like I said, we practiced this, and I wanted it to feel informal tonight. I hope it does. So the last piece on the program here is something that you'll hear again next week, but it's just fun, and I'm like, well, let's just end the school year with this. So this is a little Star Wars action. Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. So it's just been a real treat to work with all of these musicians this year. To all of you, I can't wait for those of you returning to see what we're going to do next year. And I guess I just also want to say thank you to our administration. I want to say thank you to our director, Tracy Doyle, for always taking care of us, and to my colleagues who've been so supportive. I also want to thank Greg Hearns, who's running the show here in Schneebeck, and his entire staff. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, for taking care of us on stage. And lastly, if you're watching online, hi, Mom. I know you're watching, because you always do, and I know what you're doing. You're right now in your chair, and you've got your tea and your cookie, and you're ready to go. But whether you're watching online or you're here in person, I just want to say thank you. This life is a gift, and let's just make the most of it. So enjoy what's left of the spring, and enjoy your summers. Okay, thanks for being here. Thank you.